already a superstar in India, soon to be worldwide.
I'm so used to being told, these are your lines and this is your script. This whole thing is completely different. I'm scared and nervous. I'm looking forward to this being completely new to me. Well, like I said, I hate the word crossover, so I don't believe in that. I think today the world is, the world's become a really small place. Mm-hmm. Globalization is the way forward, and, you know, ethnicity doesn't matter as much anymore.
Yep.
And I think that's it's a great time for me to be doing what I'm doing, or for me to try to do what I'm doing. So I think that as long as you're catering to a global audience, it doesn't really matter. And when it comes to my music, what I want to be able to do, whether it's my movies or my music, I want to be able to be who I am and yet be appealing to a global audience. And that, for me, that's the trick, I guess. Well, the way I see it is, you know, it's baby steps. You can't have an ambition and say, you know, I want that tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
It's the little things that you will do to get there. It's the stepping on every rung of the ladder. And for me, I started when I was 17. I was totally young. I didn't know what I was doing. I allowed myself mistakes.
Yeah.
Sometimes failure and mistakes scare people. They scared me too. Because I always try and do things that are a little to the left. They're always a little different, whether it's my choice in movies, choice in parts. I mean, which actor do you know has done music? It's bizarre for people when I say it, or when I did say it. It's always the fear of failure stops us from trying to achieve as much as we can. It's okay to fail. It's
totally
okay to say, you know what, I didn't do it right. I'll try something else. I'll try it differently. Yes, a lot of people don't get many opportunities after failure, but you can always do something different. And, you know, nothing is do or die. And I think once you start feeling that, there'll be a certain sense of confidence and a certain sense of liberation and freedom. And that's the advice I'll give someone. Don't be afraid to fail. Because the only way to go up when you're in rock bottom, the only way to go when you're in rock bottom is up.
Yeah.
So, but you know what we do when people hit rock bottom mostly, there's a romanticness to that.
Mm-hmm.
There's, you know, people romanticize being a victim. You know,
you
like being in pain.
Use it. Yeah.
And the world has, there's a persecution complex, and then the world is conspiring to ruin me and blaming everyone else. Whereas if you sit down for a couple of days, a couple of weeks, let yourself feel your failure, let yourself feel your pain, and eventually you'll get over it. But when you fight it is when there's, you know, you get into this vortex of spinning into this dark space. And most people are afraid to feel it. But it's also scary because you might get addicted to the whole I love pain thing, which is terrible and so loser-like. You know, that's never happened to me. I have never planned anything. For me, an opportunity comes and I say, oh, you know, that seems like something that people don't think I would be able to do. Let's do it. So for me, what challenges me is you know, pushing the buck a little bit and doing things that are not expected a little bit. And that's what I want to be. That's the legacy I want to leave behind. That nothing is impossible, which we hear, we read in books. But I want to be able to prove that a little bit, you know, that it's really not impossible if you put your mind to it. Like when I started movies, I told my dad, my parents asked me, do you want to, you know, because I was just 18.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, 18. They asked me, I got a lot of movie offers, and they said, you know, is this something you want to do? And I said, you know, I want to give it a shot. And my dad said, all right, take a year and a half, you know.
Yeah.
And I gave myself that much time, and I said, let me see what happens. Otherwise, I'll go back to school. I'd still be 19.
Yeah.
And I'd go to college. And so you have to treat life like that. You can't take it too seriously. That's when you start curbing yourself. You become too ambitious, and then it's all wrong. It has to be light and free and creative, and that's when the best of life can happen. I can't define success. To me, success is it's this inherent feeling of happiness.
Mm-hmm.
Success needs to make you feel like you're flying. And that's, it could be success at learning how to knit, or it could be success at you know, giving a great speech. Or
But as long as you feel internal happiness somewhere, that's
success. To me is this gratifying happiness, like when you're really hungry and you have a great meal, that is success. Well, for me, Girl Up stands for everything that needs to be about, everything that women stand for. And it's something that stands for girls all over the world. And it's a coming together of female power. And it's taking care of women. And you know, you just need something, you just need to know that someone's standing up for you. Yeah. And that's what Girl Up's doing. It stands up for you when nobody else does, which is amazing. I mean, I feel so fortunate to be, you know, their brand ambassador. I think jo creative aspect hota hai filmon ka, I think usko waisa hi chhod dena chahiye jahan pe kahaniyan hon, jahan pe jaise Pakistan mein aur India mein hum log basically to ek hi maa se paida hue hain, hum log basically to bhai behni hain. Political aspects ko chhode agar jis tarah ka hamara culture hai, jis tarah ki hamari hamare roots hain, hamare jo poets hain, دنیا بات کرتی ہے ہمارے کلچر کے بارے میں, ہماری پوئٹری کے بارے میں, ہماری کہانیوں کے بارے میں, ہماری گانوں کے بارے میں. اینڈ آئی تھنک یہ ایک بہت ہی خوبصورت بات ہے کہ جو پاکستانی فلمیں ہیں پھر سے ریوائیو ہوئی ہیں, اور جو کریٹیویٹی ہے اس کو کرب نہیں کیا جا رہا ہے. اور اینڈ آئی ہوپ, انڈیا پاکستان کو چھوڑیے, آئی جسٹ ہوپ دیٹ فلمیں جو بنتی ہیں وہ ایونچولی کیوں بنتی ہیں, تاکہ لوگ جو جائیں تھیٹر میں تین گھنٹے اپنی جو پرابلمس ہیں اس کو بھول کے انٹرٹین ہو سکیں. اینڈ بس فلمیں وہی ہونی چاہیے. اور اسپیشلی پاکستان میں اور انڈیا میں جو ہمارا ٹیلنٹ رہا ہے سالوں سال سے, آئی تھنک وہ اگر باہر آئے تو آئی تھنک ہماری فلمیں اور ہمارے روٹس اس پورے یو نو دیش کو رول کر سکتے ہیں. پاکستان جانے کا بہت شوق ہے مجھے. میرے بہت سارے دوست لاہور گئے ہیں, وہاں کی وہاں کا فیشن, وہاں کے لوگ, وہاں کا کھانا. میری فیملی ایکچولی وہیں سے آئی تھی جب آف کورس ہمارا ڈیوائڈ اینڈ رول ہوا تھا. تو میں ضرور چاہوں گی کہ ابھی میں کسی طرح کبھی ایٹ لیسٹ لاہور, پشاور, کہیں نہ کہیں تو جا سکوں. اور آئی ایم ہوپنگ کہ کسی نہ کسی دن کوئی مجھے پاکستان سے انوائٹ کرے اور میں ایکچولی وہاں آؤں. میں بس کہوں گی کہ پاکستان سے مجھے ہمیشہ بہت پیار ملا ہے, بہت عزت ملی ہے, میری فلمیں ہوں یا جو بھی میں نے کوشش کی ہے کرنے کی. اور اگر وہ پیار برقرار رہے تو مجھے ہمیشہ ایک طرح سے کریج اور کانفیڈنس ملے گا کہ میں زندگی میں کچھ بھی کر سکتی ہوں اور آپ کو ہمیشہ انٹرٹین کرتی رہوں گی. سو تھینک یو سو مچ کہ آپ نے مجھے اتنی عزت دی اور اتنی عزت افزائی کی میری.
اٹس بین اے ویری اسپیشل جرنی, اٹس بین ون آف دا موسٹ انریچنگ ایکسپیرینسز آف مائی لائف, اینڈ آئی ریمبر اٹ آلویز. گڈ بائے, اگلی ول بی مائن ٹو ریمبر.